Hi, welcome to PRINCE2 interview questions webinar. I am Chandra MR, a certified ITIL expert, ITIL MP, managing professional, ITIL for managing professional, PMP, PRINCE2, Agile Scrum Master, COBIT, DevOps. So today I'm going to present to you on all those probable questions which would come to any certified PRINCE2 practitioner or foundation certification holder. So firstly, we need to understand what is this PRINCE2 certification is all about. So before we speak about PRINCE2 certification, one has to understand a certificate, as you see, a digital copy or a hard copy. It speaks about that you have successfully appeared in the examination of that particular certification and you obtained that certificate. But however, the certificate remains as it is unless you do not demonstrate in the real time. It is very essential. Don't just have the certificate. Better you practice it and live up to that expectation of the certification, certified professional, which any organization would look up to. So PRINCE2 certification perspective, PRINCE2 certification is a project management certification where PRINCE2 stands for Projects in Controlled Environment. So PRINCE2 certification is globally recognized, acknowledged professional certification for project management, which is owned by Axelos Limited. And this projects using PRINCE2 methodology, wherever they adapt and adopt the PRINCE2 methodology, has a proven history in terms of achieving those results in a controlled manner, and projects would become successful. So what do you understand by project? So the basic definition of project goes with: a project is a temporary endeavor which is undertaken to produce a unique product or solution. When we say this, the output of a project will be a product, a service, or a result, which is unique in nature. So you may produce a similar product with the same features, functionality, everything. Still, the specific objective of that project, the specific output of that project, what is intended to accomplish, that will become unique. So every project will have a definite beginning and end. So it starts on a certain date and ends on a certain date after completion of that particular objective of the project. It may get closed prematurely also because of the changed business reasons, but it will have a definitely a beginning and end for every project. It doesn't mean that it should be for few months or few days. It can go up to many years as well. So that is the reason we call a project as a temporary endeavor. A project that does not have this properties, one cannot able to become successful and cannot able to create that results what is required. Then what are the seven principles of PRINCE2? So PRINCE2 methodology specifies, mention in specific, four integrated elements, where principle is one of that integrated element which comes first. So the seven principles of PRINCE2 defined in PRINCE2 are: continued business justification, learn from experience, define roles and responsibilities, manage by stages, manage by exception, focus on products, and tailor to suit the project. So when we say continued business justification, project's viability, desirability, and feasibility has to be justified throughout the project lifecycle. Initially, while taking up the project, one has to justify why should we take up this project. Similarly, as we progress in the project, one has to justify that project is progressing the way it is expected. And it justifies, the justification continues, should continue throughout the project lifecycle, which needs to be checked. Then as you initiate a project, as you take up a project, while planning, definitely you may require to check on all those learnings which you have from the previous project. That is one way of looking at learn from experience. Secondly, as you progress in a project, the learning within this project in the previous stages needs to be taken up, and necessary actions needs to be taken to avoid any such deviations which had occurred, and project can move smoother. So every project should have a set of roles and responsibilities assigned, and this can bring in a proper structure for the project organization. And as per this principle, manage by stages, it recommends to have minimum two stages, one initiation stage and one management stage, to make the project successful. Minimum two stages. It can be any number of management stages, but minimum are two. Manage by exception refers to the scenario where there may be a deviation which happens as you progress in the project. One has to learn what is the deviation and do the necessary corrections. That's what principle manage by exception is stressing upon. When we say focus on product basically is mentioning about the products which are being delivered as an output of the projects. The specification, the parameters, the features, functionality has to be clearly articulated and defined. Similarly, every project what you do in a different environment is based on the context, various different contexts of the project. It may be a small project, it may be a big project, it may be complex, it may be public place, it may be in a controlled office environment, it may be in a financial related, it may be a IT related, it may be a civil construction. So every project is unique in nature. So each foot, while applying PRINCE2 methodologies, every project needs to be looked at and the methods has to be tailored. But none of these principles can be tailored because the principles are universal and self-validating. So these needs to be demonstrated, but these cannot be tailored. Question 4, what are the 7 themes of PRINCE2? So themes being again part of 4 integrated elements indicated mentioned in PRINCE2 framework. So 7 themes basically focuses on providing the insights in terms of what kind of products needs to be used while delivering the project, like business case as a product, benefits management product as a specific one of the management product, then quality registers, communication management approach, reports templates. It throws the light and it provides the necessary insights for a project organization to be ready with those management product to manage the project properly. So those 7 themes are business case theme, organization theme, quality theme, risk theme, plans theme, change theme, and progress theme. So what are the 7 processes of PRINCE2? So processes being one of the 4 integrated elements of PRINCE2's framework. So each of these process has its role in the project life cycle. So starting up a project process is the one which is triggered in the pre-project stage, which creates a specific project request for initiating a project. It produces that. You may have the project brief created as part of this project. Outline business case is created as part of this particular process. And once that is done, a request is sent to directing a project process to approve the initiation of project. Now, initiating a project process, which gets triggered from the directing a project process after the approval of request to initiate a project. And this process is in the initiation stage of the project. Now, this particular process, in this process, you would create the detailed business case, a project initiation documentation, a detailed plan, and that request for initiation is again sent back to directing a project process, where after approval of that, project can move towards the management stages. So directing a project process is the one which is a single common process across the project lifecycle, irrespective of the stages, which is exclusively for directing a project for project board. This is done by a project board, right? So every approvals like a request to initiate a project, request to delivering that project, then approval of the exception, giving ad hoc directions, all these activities would be done by directing a project process. So managing a product delivery is the process which is exclusively dedicated to the stage, not the stage, the level of product delivery layer in the various 4 layers. If you look at the 4 layers in the project organization, one is directing layer where you see project board, other one is management layer where you see project management, other one is delivery layer where you see product delivery is happening in a project. So this process is dedicated to that layer, delivery layer, where team manager plays an important role here. Now, 5th process, controlling a stage is a process where this is in the layer management, process in the management layer, where through this process, project manager will be able to ensure the project management successfully so that all those monitoring and control requirement for project management is done by controlling a stage process in a given management stage. Managing a stage boundary process is the one which is triggered as the stage boundary approaches. As a stage boundary is nearing, managing a stage boundary process is triggered, and this would capture all those details of performance, the way project is progressing and what is accomplished in that stage. And also it would provide the exception plan. It would also provide the details of plan for the next stage. And then that is sent to directing a project process for necessary approvals. Then closing a project process is the one which is triggered in the last management stage of the project. So where managing a stage boundary process will be triggered in all the management stages, end of the management stages, except last management stage. Whereas in the last management stage, closing a project process will be triggered to formally initiate the closure of the project. Question 6, list down the key features of PRINCE2 certification. So the one who is certified PRINCE2 should able to demonstrate, basically all the speakers should able to see this happening in their projects. Like this helps in focusing on business justification. This helps in defining proper organization structure for the project. And one could able to get the insights of product-based planning approach. Project can be divided into multiple manageable stages. Maintains the consistency. Enhances the reusability. Flexibility can be applied at any level. And provides invaluable diagnostic tools. But you should remember, PRINCE2 as a best practices will not provide you any specialization in any of the techniques as such, like tools and technologies. It does not provide you that insights. Leadership capability, you know, PRINCE2 certification will not speak about it. All that PRINCE2 certification focuses on a project management and all this four integrated elements which we spoke earlier, that is principles, themes, processes, and tailoring to suit the project environment. And focusing on that helps in these points what we mentioned to accomplish in every project. So 7, what are the various steps involved in directing a project process? So directing a project process will have various 5 activities, that is authorizing initiation, authorizing the project, authorizing a stage or exception plan, giving an ad hoc direction, authorizing the project closure. So question 8, what are the various types of documentation used in PRINCE2 methodology for storing and reporting project related data? So various different documentation used in PRINCE2 methodology, there's a huge list of documentation. However, some of the few to mention, to give an example, like a business case, risk register, quality register, issue log, daily log, which would be the main set of project related reporting, storing and reporting documentation, which would help in capturing and tracking the progress of the project throughout the project lifecycle. So define a plan in PRINCE2 methodology. So a plan in a PRINCE2 methodology focuses on 6 aspects of the project, basically scope, timelines that is schedule, cost that is budget, quality, risk, resources, communication, benefits realization. So 6 aspects, if I want to mention in specific, that would be scope, timelines, cost, quality, risk, and benefits. So keeping these 6 aspects in mind, a project management methodology of PRINCE2 focuses on planning, all that required for planning to accomplish the results of the project. Question number 10, in PRINCE2 methodology, what are the various levels of plan? So project plan is created to have an outlook of entire project, a holistic picture, a full details of a project at the project level, which will be basically with the project board. Now stage plan will be done at the management layer, where exclusively for a specific stage, detailed planning will be made based on the project plan which is defined. So stage plan is the next level. So third level is the team plan, which will be created at the delivery layer. So team plan can be optional depending on the requirements or complexity of the project. Team plans can be made. If it is a simple project, team plan may not be required. Similarly, another type of plan which comes across is exception plan. Basically, you see this plan in a management layer, in a scenario wherever there is a deviation occurs, exception occurs. Question 11, list down the various steps involved in planning. So the various steps involved in planning involves designing the plan, defining the products, identifying activities and dependencies, prepare estimates, prepare schedule, document plan, and identify risks. So designing a plan is an overall picture in terms of creating and defining what are the management stages, what are the focus area in each of those management stages. Similarly, defining a products refers to focusing on those products, product breakdown, the features, functionality of the products. So as you define that, that needs to be delivered by doing certain activities. So for that, you need to identify the activities, dependencies between those deliverables, dependency of the activities, then preparing the estimates. Estimates in terms of efforts, estimate in terms of cost, then you sequence and prepare the schedule. And consolidating all of this, you document that plan. And to this plan, what are the associated risks at various different levels will be identified. So risk can be for the product, risk can be for the activities, risk can be on the estimations which is done on the cost or efforts, risk can be on the schedule perspective. So considering all of this, a comprehensive project management plan will be created. Then question number 12, can you name the progress controls provided by PRINCE2 methodology? So basically there are 2 types of progress controls provided by PRINCE2 methodology. When you say provided, basically recommended, mentioned. It is event-driven progress control and time-driven progress control. As the name itself indicates, when we say event-driven, whenever certain things occurs. So in that scenario, you may require to mention like milestone deliverable, something failed, something accomplished. These are all the events. So in this occurrence of the event, you need to check whether everything is delivered as per the plan or not, establish the control there. Time driven. So it's like every week, every fortnight, every month, I do these checks, I do this exercise to see whether things are moving in the required directions. That is time driven. So next question number 13, what do you understand by directing a project? Now, directing a project helps the project board to be accountable for project's success. It helps the project manager in making key decisions. It also aids in exercising overall control, all while delegating the day-to-day management of the project. So meaning, we saw the directing a project process, which is a dedicated process at the directing layer for the project board, which can exercise all those required controls. Question number 14, what are the various objectives of directing a project? So the various objectives of directing a project is, it is an authority which makes the critical decisions, which project management layer means project manager cannot do, and deliver the project deliverables in the sense it has to have that insight on progressing of the project and provides the necessary directions for deliverables. Then provide the better direction and control, properly structured interface, authority to close the project. So as the project closure approaches, so authorization to close the project will be provided based on the recommendations or based on the details produced by management layer. So post-project benefits are managed and reviewed with the corporate program management or customer. Question number 15, during which process of PRINCE2 methodology is the request to approve the next stage plan made? As I mentioned, in the management layer, you have a controlling stage, managing stage boundary, closing a project process, and initiating a project process. So in all of these management stages, including initiation stage, except the last stage, or last management stage, in the stage boundary of each of those stages, you will have managing a stage boundary process. So this process is exclusively to capture the details of accomplishment of the stage, what went well, what went wrong, how the project is progressing, and then you would also provide the plan for the next stage. So that happens through managing a stage boundary process. Question number 16, explain quality planning and quality control. Now, quality planning refers to the process of identifying the quality requirements of a project. It is a process of identifying the quality requirements of the project, which helps in providing the insight towards what exactly the features, functionality, what exactly the approach towards quality management, along with the required artifacts like updating the quality register. And then quality control focuses on execution plan, the finished products, conducts the quality test on the products which have been delivered at various different stages of the project and also at the end of the project. So quality control focuses on the product measurements, whereas quality planning focuses on creating the required quality management approach and updating the quality register as well, creating all the required templates for quality management. Question number 17, in PRINCE2 methodology, which document is used for recording the planned and actual dates of product approval and handover? So in PRINCE2 methodology, product checklist document is used for recording the planned and actual dates of product approval and handover. Question 18, why the 7 principles are important in PRINCE2 project management methodology? So the 7 principles, which are part of integrated elements, 4 integrated elements of project, which is defined in PRINCE2. So principles refers to the notion that project management practitioner must follow. They should demonstrate that. So principles are developed on basis of past experience of project managers across the globe, their experiences, and all those ideas and concepts have been filtered and compressed into set of everyday activities and behavior. And remember, these 7 principles defined in PRINCE2 are universal and self-validating, which cannot be tailored. So the principles helps in easy management and execution of the project, since it's a specific directions and provide the required insight. The question 19, who is responsible for establishing project tolerance in PRINCE2 methodology? So the project tolerances are set at various different levels. Corporate program management or the customer sets tolerances to the project board at the project level, whereas project board sets the tolerances to the project manager, that is a stage tolerance basically. Then project manager set tolerances to the team manager for the delivery layer, that is at the work package tolerance. So each of these tolerance levels are used to check whether is there any deviation, if there any exception occurred. Question 20, using which process you can easily integrate the non-PRINCE2 practices into PRINCE2 project environment while developing products? So managing product delivery process can be easily used, can be used to look at delivering the work packages. And generally, I think any best practices PRINCE2 also being a best practice, can use non-PRINCE2 practices to bring in as and when needed. The tools and technology, the tools and specific techniques, definitely PRINCE2 doesn't mention. You can use that as part of this process since the work packages are delivered through this particular process. So question 21, differentiate between avoiding a threat and reducing a threat. So what is a threat? Threat is basically a negative impacting thing, right? So avoiding a threat in the sense, I don't even take up that risk. I don't even take up that project. I don't even take up that assignment. So that, like for example, you have a risk of falling down if you walk. So I don't even walk. That is avoiding risk. You have a risk of hitting someone if you drive something, like falling or accident is one of the risks if you drive. So I don't even drive. So like I don't even take up that assignment. So that is avoiding threat. Reducing the threat is basically doing all those required necessary actions so that impact of that risk will be reduced. So let us look at by definition, what does it say? So avoiding a threat is basically a process where the project is altered in order to prevent the risk from occurring. Meaning I don't even take up that mostly. Then reducing a threat is basically attempt to reduce the risk probability and its impact. Means I set up all those necessary actions taken. Like power going off is a threat for a project. Now I will have an UPS. I will have a generator. So meaning the level of threat it has is reduced now. The probability of that occurrence of that risk is reduced. So then list down the various type of projects. So the various types of projects can be a compulsory project for an organization. Without that, organization cannot sustain. It may be a project for not-for-profit organization. It may be an external project done for a customer. External customer. Evolving requirements based on the changing trend. Projects would be taken to suit that changing demand. Then multi-organization projects. So multiple organization involved to accomplish certain common objective, such projects. Question 23, what are the various deliverables offered by PRINCE2? So PRINCE2 deliverables would be like business case, end of the stage report, project plan, issue log, work package, risk management plan, and list continues. Like benefit management approach, highlight report, checkpoint report, the list continues. So these are the few to mention. And these are again a management products. These are all not the ultimate result of the product. These management products are used to create the ultimate output of the project. Question 24, who is responsible for the authorization of the project initiation? So project board, which will involve a project executive, a senior users and senior suppliers, authorize the project whenever there is a request for initiation comes from the starting up the project process. As I mentioned earlier, starting up the project process is in the pre-project stage, which submits the request to directing a project process to initiate a project. Request to initiate a project. Question 25, why a project is split into number of stages? So as we see in the principle managed by stages, it is very essential the projects needs to be handled better by controlling through managing stages. So minimum two stages, one initiation, one management stages was recommended minimum. This will help in terms of better control and execution over the project. Helps the project manager to break down the entire project activities into manageable chunks. Then similar kind of work can be grouped together and the funds and resources can be allocated better to each stages, right? Then increase in the efficiency and reduce the unnecessary wastage of money. Then responding to the customer's need becomes easier. Question number 26, which document is used to define the acceptance criteria and roles for the projects in PRINCE2 methodology? So the list of documents, basically the details of the deliverable, the product which is being created as part of the project, the output is captured in project product description. So this captures the details of the project's product which is being delivered, and it will also have acceptance criteria. Question 27, during which process of PRINCE2 based project a checkpoint report is produced? So basically checkpoint report is produced by a delivery layer, that is by team manager. So at that layer, managing a product delivery is the process which is used for producing a checkpoint report. Question 28, what are the three steps of quality review techniques? So the three steps of quality review techniques involves preparation, then review meeting, and the follow-up after the meeting for the action items defined. Question 29, what do you understand by configuration management PRINCE2 methodology? So configuration management, when you say, it's about capturing the details of configuration items, which helps in terms of technical and administrative activity has to be done that mainly focuses on creating, maintaining, and controlling the change of configuration. Then a configuration item is the main entity which is subjected to configuration management. And this entity can be simple component of a product or a set of products which are to be released to the customer. And these configuration items are used to create the products, and these would be the resources which are used to or may become part of the ultimate output product comes out of the project. Question 30, list down a few risk strategies implemented in PRINCE2 projects. So the risk tolerance, risk appetite, ongoing activity of risk management, and avoiding, seeking, and being neutral in risk related things. When I say risk tolerance, it refers to the amount of risk that an investor is comfortable taking or the degree of uncertainty that an investor is able to handle. An example, if you take an investing scenario, risk appetite refers to level of risk that an organization is prepared to accept in pursuit of its objectives before action is deemed necessary to reduce the risk. Whereas ongoing activities, all those activities, management activities for risk management defined while implementing the risk responses, while handling the occurrence of that risk, actually the risk event occurred, which has become an issue, handling those issues required ongoing activities there also. Secondly, risk avoid, that risk averse behavior of an organization where not even taking the risk or looking out for risk, whichever comes across, regularly checking what are the new risks which comes across, and being neutral for the risk, certain kind of risk, which we observe the scenarios of that and then take the necessary calls. Question 31, which PRINCE2 theme addresses the ongoing viability of the different project plans? So progress theme focuses on the ongoing active viability of the different project plans. So plan is done as the project progresses. You need to check how the project is progressing. So progress theme focuses on this aspect of it. Question 32, differentiate between the starting up a project process and initiating a project process. So as I mentioned earlier, starting up the project process is in the pre-project stage, whereas initiating a project is in the initiation stage of a project. So starting up a project process captures all the information required and to make a quick decision whether the project is viable, worthwhile to take up. So this creates outline business case and project brief. Whereas initiating project process is in initiation stage, which will be initiated after getting the necessary approval given by the directing a project process after receiving a request from starting up the project process to initiate a project. So this creates the detailed business case, this creates the project initiation documentation, and this defines the governance of the project and project management approaches required in detail. So question number 33, what is the use of PRINCE2 method? So PRINCE2 method integrates different methodologies, adds required flexibilities to the project, and it makes project more responsive, then aids in deciding project team and assigning responsibilities, and helps in provides necessary guidance in information gathering also, which becomes easy and effective. Question 34, who are considered as the primary stakeholders in a PRINCE2 project? So the primary stakeholders of PRINCE2 projects are users, suppliers, and business sponsors. Basically, business sponsors are represented by business executives. Users' representation is from the senior users, and suppliers' representation will be senior suppliers. So in a project board, you can see that these three roles. So business executive is a single individual, cannot be delegated, and it cannot be with the multiple people. So that a single individual focus on the business objective of it. Whereas representation of senior users in the project board happens from the mostly senior personnel of that particular user group or user community who represent that entire users community and be there and on behalf of them to safeguard the user's interest. Similarly, to safeguard the supplier's interest, there will be senior suppliers based on the number of suppliers are in the specific project, and those senior suppliers represent each of those supplier entities. So question 35, differentiate between risk quality and issue register. Now risk register particularly used to capture all those identified risks. Now identification of risk doesn't happen at one part of the project, not at the starting of the project, not at the end of the project. It has to happen throughout the project life cycle, from the point initially when decided we need to take up this project. From that point, the risk identification, risk evaluation, and re-evaluating the identified risk should keep going, and those needs to be captured in risk register. So quality registers contains all the required quality activities and details required in terms of what is that we need to accomplish as part of the quality management, what is the targets needs to be achieved. So issue register will have the details of the specific issues which are occurred, like change requests, the complaints, the concerns, the failures, the problems. Issue register will help in tracking for the closure of the issues, whereas risk register helps in having the insight towards the probable risk and initiating the required actions to mitigate that risk or reduce the impact of the risk. Whereas quality registers are used to track all the quality management activities. Then question number 36, in which process risk management strategy created in PRINCE2 methodology? So risk management strategy is created in the initiating a project process, which is in initiation stage of the project life cycle. Question 37, who determines the change authority and change budget in PRINCE2? So project executive, who is part of a project board in the directing layer of the project, the change authority and change budgets are determined. Question 38, in which process is the status of work packages reviewed? So the status of the work package is reviewed in the controlling stage process. This is the process where project manager would be using in all the management stages and have a close interface with the managing product delivery to check on the status of reviewing the status of work packages throughout the stages. Question 39, who is responsible for maintaining the quality register? So quality register would be maintained by project support, which is assisting project manager to maintain and manage, update various different product like quality register, risk register, etc. Then question 40, differentiate between the request for change and off specification and problem or concern in PRINCE2. So when you have a specific changes needs to be initiated, that would be initiated because of three reasons, which we call it as an issue, which is termed as request for change, off specification and problem. So request for change refers to that a customer makes or adding into a changing either scope or quality of the product or anything, customer request, these changes are required. A formally request for the changes, which would be basically a deviation from what is agreed already. So this is done formally. Off specification, where there is some deviations which has occurred. There is a plan which you need to accomplish. There is something to deliver which you're looking for, but that did not happen. There is a deviation. That is off specification. Whereas a problem or a concern refers to something which can throw the project off the track. So this identification of problem should happen, and that needs to be handled proactively. So reactive problem management is always results based on the impact what will have on the project. So it is recommended to have a proactive problem management. Question 41, how many products have been defined in PRINCE2 and what are they? So there are various management products which are defined as part of PRINCE2 methodology. So these are the list, and all these management products are used throughout the project lifecycle to produce the project's product. So like benefits review plan, business case, checkpoint report, communication management strategy, configuration item record, configuration management strategy, daily log, end project report, end stage report, exception report, highlight report, issue register, issue report, lessons log, lessons report, plan for project at stage level and the team, I mean delivery level, delivery layer, product description, product status account, project brief, project initiation documentation, project product description, quality management strategy, quality register, risk management strategy, risk register, work package. Question 42, which process can be carried out without following the closing a project process? So managing product delivery process can be carried out without following a closing a project process, which means this process is not directly going to trigger the closing a project process, obviously. So it has to go back to controlling a stage process, and then controlling a stage process would trigger that end of the project process, that is closing a project process. So which role is responsible for confirming the stage and project progress against the agreed tolerance? So project assurance role would be responsible for confirming at the each stage as the project progresses against the agreed tolerances. Is that within the tolerance or is it deviation? Is there any deviation from the agreed one? Question 44, who is responsible for creating a product status account? So product status account will be created by project support and it is maintained by project support. Question 45, list down the various activities involving in managing a stage boundary process. So planning for the next stage, updating the project plan and business case, reporting the stage and producing an exception plan would be the activities involved in managing a stage boundary process. Question 46, what are the four integrated elements of PRINCE2? So the four integrated elements of PRINCE2 are principles, themes, processes, and then tailoring to suit the project environment. Question 47, what do you understand by tailoring in PRINCE2? So tailoring refers to adaptation. So every project comes with a different scenario. So any project, whatever you have in hand, has to ensure that it is relevant, it is appropriate, so that there is an appropriate amount of planning, control, governance, and use of processes and themes which is suitable to that particular project's context. So that is the reason a tailoring is recommended, tailoring is stressed upon in the PRINCE2 methodology. Question 48, which process is responsible for triggering the request to deliver a project? So triggering the request to deliver a project is done by initiating a project process in the initiation stage. Question 49, what is the difference between controlling a stage, managing product delivery, and managing a stage boundary? Now, controlling a stage is a process which is in the management layer, where managing the project on day-to-day basis is done by the project manager. Whereas managing a product delivery will focus on delivering those products of the project, and this has a close interface with the controlling a stage process. And controlling a stage process authorizes the work package to managing a product delivery process. And as that work package is delivered, then that comes back to the controlling a stage process to update, and that continues. And as these products which are planned for that specific stage, as the stage end appears, comes up. So managing a stage boundary process is triggered by controlling a stage process, so that all the stage boundary activities can be done before moving to the next stage. Question 50, what is the business case in PRINCE2 methodology? So basically, as I mentioned multiple times, the business case is needed to capture all the details in terms of to check the project's viability, project's desirability, whether should we do this project or not, which gets created in the pre-project stage itself. From there, next in the initiation stage, a detailed business case will get created, whereas outline business case is created in pre-project stage. Now, as the project progresses, you know, to check the viability, desirability, whether project is still justifiable throughout the project lifecycle using this business case, which helps in revalidating the project and also helps in making a decision to kickstart the project. And this helps in terms of business to have a better insight to make a right decision to take a project or to continue with that project. And that's all about possible interview questions related to PRINCE2. I hope these set of questions will help you while attending the interview, being a PRINCE2 certified professional. Thank you very much. So we will again look at in the upcoming webinars. See you there. Take care.
I hope you have enjoyed listening to this video. Please be kind enough to like it, and you can comment any of your doubts and queries, and we will reply them at the earliest. Do look out for more videos in our playlist and subscribe to Edureka channel to learn more. Happy learning!